Okay, we're going to find the derivative of x to the x, and I'm going to show you guys two ways to do it. The first way is more of the traditional way, the textbook way, all right? Well, first, I'm going to say y is equal to x to the x power, and we are going to find dy dx, or y prime, all right? And here's the trouble. This is not a polynomial. This is not an exponential function. It's kind of like both, because we have the x in the base and also the x in the power. Whenever we have a function to a function, this is what we can do. We write it down as y equal x to the x, and then we do the natural log both sides. So let's take the natural log, the ln, both sides like this. And then reason is because now on this side here, x to the x, this is the power x right here. We can take this to the front, isn't it? And we can look at this as ln y equal to x, right? This x is in the front now, and we multiply by ln x. And now, on the right-hand side, this is just a product of two functions. We can use the product rule, right? And here's the trouble, though. As we can see, we have ln y. While it's not isolated in this case, what we can do is you have another two way. You can do e to this power, e to that power, and in fact, that's what I'm going to show you guys later on. So let's not do that. Another way is we can just deal with this by doing implicit differentiation because the y is inside of the ln. And this is how I'm going to do it. I will just put down d dx throughout this equation. We'll do implicit differentiation. And here we go. Ln y, we know the derivative of that. It's going to be 1 over y, 1 over the inside, which is the y. Furthermore, we know y is a function of x. So by the chain rule, we have to multiply by the derivative of y with respect to x. In another word, we multiply by dy dx like that. All right? So we are done on the left-hand side. And now on the right-hand side, we are just going to be using the product rule and do the derivative the usual way. I'm going to keep the first function, which is x, and I'll multiply by the derivative of the second. The derivative of ln x with respect to x is just 1 over x. And then we add the second function, which is ln x, and we multiply by the derivative of the first. Derivative of x in the x world is just 1, like that. Okay, now, you see, this is just going to be 1 over y, and this is the dy dx that we want to find. On the right-hand side, of course, x times 1 over x is just 1. Ln x times 1 is just ln x, so we have 1 plus ln x, like that. We are done, because here we have 1 over y. The moment we multiply both sides by y, right, this is y times this entire right-hand side. You see that the y and that will cancel, and we will just have dy dx equal to y times this. This is not putting a function inside of the y. This is y times this. And what's y in terms of x? Originally, y is the same as x to the x power. So we can just write this down as y as x to the x power times this right here, which is 1 plus ln x. And that's it. This is one way to do it, right? And now the second way is the following. And I'll use a slightly different notation as well. Suppose I want to do the derivative, right? So d dx of the function x to the x like this. Same thing, isn't it? Earlier, I just called y to be that function and then find the dy dx. Here, the trouble is still that we have a function to a function power. Do not bring the power to the front and minus 1. That doesn't work, all right? That's only for power function when you have x to the 5th power or x to the 7th power, or things like that, all right? In this case, this is what we do. Look at the x right here. And we are going to use some kind of natural log and also the ln. We don't know how to deal with this x too well because we have x to this power x. That's not so good. I want to change this x from the base to actually a number. And the best number that we can use is e, right? In terms of differentiating, e to the something, it's the easiest to differentiate. Look at, here is the note right here. I really want to deal with e. So if you look at e, and you are going to ask yourself, e to what power will give us x? Well, this right here is going to be an exponential function. You are just going to, you know, invite the inverse function of the exponential so that they will cancel each other out. In another word, if I have e raised to the ln x, e and ln will cancel out, I'll just end up with x. And now I'm going to look at this backwards. X is the same as e to the ln x. I will put this right here for this x so that I can produce the e for my base. Right here, we're just kind of doing algebra, so I'll just still put down the d dx because we haven't differentiated anything yet. This x is e to the natural log of x now, so let me just write down nicely for you guys like that. And then don't forget, we still have to raise that to the x power right here. Right? So we do have the e for the base now. We have a power to another power. What should we do with the powers? Multiply them, right? So now this is still, we haven't done differentiation yet. We will have e and then x times ln x, all right? In another word, yes, x to the x power is nothing but the same as e to the x times ln x, all right? By looking at this form, we can differentiate because the base is just a number now, and this is the best number that we like when we are talking about differentiating. So this is the calculus in action. E to the something, the derivative of that, we first repeat this, right? So we will have e to the x times ln x like this. And then the chain rule says, because right here, it's a function, we have to multiply by the derivative right here, right? So let's see what we have. On top of that, this is a product of two functions. We have to use the product rule. I'm going to keep the first function, which is x, times the derivative of second, which is 1 over x, and then we add the second function, which is ln x, and times the derivative of the first, which is just 1. I know it's the same thing over there, right? And you will see, this right here is going to be 1, and this is just ln x. And what's e to the x times ln x? It was right here. It was just x to the x power. So let me write this down as x to the x power, and we are pretty much done because right here this is just 1, and then this is just plus ln x. And as you can see, we are done. Same answer both ways. That's it.